Efunsetan Aniwura, the great Iyalode of Ibadan, was a wealthy and powerful man of unusual boldness, strength, and intelligence. According to accounts of books, biographies, and films about her, she reigned as the Iyalode of Ibadan for years. No light was shed about her husband, but she had only one child, a girl child who died between the ages of 19 to 22 through the process of child labor. Efunsetan was a very close friend of Madame Tinubu, the Iyalode of Egba. They were wealthy women in their days. Till date, it is said that Efunsetan was the boldest, most powerful, and wealthiest Iyalode that reigned in Yoruba land. Her glory was rare and couldn't be compared to any other during her reign. Efunsetan was a businesswoman who traveled around the country to buy products like bitter cola, kola nut, cocoa, and so on. She was well known among the Hausas and the Western states. She was among the first women that had business transactions with the white men. This also helped Ibadan in civilizing the people. Efunsetan had her own warriors and slaves like the king and released them for war in favor of her people. During her days, she helped in improving the economy of Ibadan through business transactions. She was among the first women that had business transactions with the white people, and this really civilized Ibadan. All of her achievements made her very popular and she was loved by all. Although very strict woman, she was very nice to her slaves and employees. She gave gifts and money to them freely at times without measure. A story was cited about a slave of hers who delivered a baby in her absence. At her return, she gave her food, clothing, and money. She even gave out her slaves in marriages and conducted naming ceremonies for them. But all this stopped after the death of her beloved daughter. After the death of her daughter, everything took a new turn. She was no longer submissive to God or the king, for according to her, God has failed her. So God should manage his heaven while she manages her own head. She kills her slaves at will for committing atrocities, either by beheading or poisoning them. She gave a sanction that no cry of a child must be heard in her domain, neither must there be conception, courtship, or marriage take place. Efunsetan became so dreadful and many people feared her to the extent of avoiding passing the front of her house to any destination. Anyone that dares passes her entrance automatically becomes her slave. It is said that she will arrogantly come out of her chambers, boast, and say, "Eru mile kan loni," meaning, "I have an additional slave today." Efunsetan had 200 slaves at that time. It was said that she was very powerful in terms of diabolic powers. It was not stated if she actually belonged to any cult group like the Ifa, Oshu, or witches, but she had extraordinary power to know things around her, just like the witches. It happened in her quarters one day. A slave of hers got pregnant for another slave, knowing fully well their mistress rules and regulations. The pregnant slave decided to conspire with Efunsetan's brother just to save her life and her babies. Efunsetan's brother decided to claim the pregnancy. Efunsetan found out through her diabolic powers and got angry. She killed everyone involved in the plot after she had beheaded the slave girl at the village square. She went ahead and beheaded everyone that pleaded she should have mercy on the slave girl and her lover. It was recorded that she beheaded close to 41 heads. The king found out of all her atrocities and summoned her to be brought to the palace with immediate effect, but all efforts to bring her to the palace got abortive. So the king decided to go himself with the palace guard after rubbing all sorts of shams on his body. At her house, she asked for the reason for their visit and she was told. She asked if she could be excused to pick something inside it. She went back into her room and killed herself with machete poison, saying "Kakaki leku iliasha," meaning it's better to die than to face the shame of being arrested, ridiculed, or punished. After her death, all her slaves were set free. Some returned to their villages, while some remained in Ibadan, Oyo State. Efunseton was a woman of great principle. She was also beautiful, wealthy, and proud, which led to her destruction. Hope you enjoyed this interesting story of Efunseton Anura. Kindly click on the subscribe button and don't forget to like and comment. Thank you for watching.